I finally got one. Beautiful, isn't it?
So the other day I was thinking about my channel name and I was like, well, I'm called JT Picks because my name starts with a J, my last name starts with a T, and I pick music. So yeah, but then I thought, you know what, so far I've done reviews, reactions, even some stuff on movies, but what if I could take my channel name and turn it into a regular series? So that's what I'm doing. So JT will pick. And that's it. It's exactly what this series is going to be all about. I'm going to be picking artists that I like who I feel like they need to be brought into the spotlight. And I'm just going to talk about them. Their best songs, their best albums, just everything about them that is absolutely amazing and why I love these artists and feel like they need to be brought into that spotlight. So here we go. And today's episode is about, drumroll please, Adrian Sings. If you don't know who Adrian Sings is, he is quite a, I wish I could say he was like a super popular rapper, but he's not. But I do like my low-key independent artists here and there. Adrian Sings honestly has one of the most diverse musical acts I have ever seen in my life. He could do pop, hip-hop, and he's in an alternative band called After Midnight. I mean, it's kind of crazy. I recently DM'd After Midnight and I was like, hey,
are you guys coming out with an album? Because I don't like it when just people drop singles.
And they answered me back. How many artists, no matter how small they are, I DM answer back? Like, none. But he actually answered back and said, yeah, we're working on an album. So, news. After Midnight's coming out with an album. I don't know when, but it'll be amazing, and they're coming out with a single this Friday called Waves, and I suggest you listen to it because I heard the preview and it sounds amazing. But yeah, Adrian Sings is an amazing rapper. First, I love his versatility, right? So I already mentioned how he has different like styles, like he's done pop, hip hop, and alternative. He showcases from each album different aspects of himself. On his first album, his first album was kind of forgettable to me. Sorry, I love you, Adrian Sings, but it was. I mean, No Se was probably the highlight of that album, and just, other than that, I was like, meh. Lost in Space is where it gets interesting, which is his second album. In Lost in Space, he has a song, Up or Down, featuring Joy Ventas, the GOAT, and he does this flow that's amazing. It's almost like NF-ish. So, have you heard the song Why, where NF basically raps, I just want to feel alive until I die, this isn't Nace Flow, just let me rhyme, I'm in the skies. That part was one of the highlights of that song. Adrian Sings does something really similar, where he starts rapping, and the exact words of the rap aren't coming to my mind, but he does something very similar, where it's like, na 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 na, and then he goes, why? Because this flow's dead, though. And I mean, you know what? I'm just going to play the song so y'all can hear it. Okay? I think it's one of his best. He has a ton of good songs. Again, let's see. His first album is called 1995. Again, good stuff, but I don't love it. The best song on that album is No Se. This one. But I mean, I don't love it too much. But his next album is not Lost in Space. Excuse me. I thought it was called Lost in Space. It's called Odyssey. It's probably because the album cover confused me. I'll show you the album cover quickly. You'll see why I'm confused. Look at that album cover. It's literally, he's an astronaut going through space and he's like reaching out. That's why I thought it was called Lost in Space. But
trust when I'm hitting my pride. Came up from nothing and known for the ride. Trusting in God when I can't see the light. I'm on my grind, like it's my time. See a me, but I don't mind, cause I'm alive. This flow is dead, though it's fine. I'll run them live until it's mine. Let them know I gotta shine. What you expect from me?
This flow is dead, though. I mean, I love that so much. And then, you know, if that wasn't good enough for you, you got Joey to make it so much better. So, I mean, that's good. He's also got this song that was mad underrated in this album called Let It Shine, featuring Ruslan. Now, Ruslan, he's an OG. He's been in the rap game not as long as Lecrae or, you know, them, but he's been in it quite a while. And, you know, to the point where he's like, you know, a vet. And just the style of this song is called Let It Shine. I love it. It seems like in this album, Adrian Sings was like, you know, experimenting with different sounds. Because that one was like more regular hip hop, but with a modern tone to it. But not too hard, but not too soft, if you know what I mean. So here's Let It Shine. I love this song. This guy's flow, I'm serious. Adrian Sings has a flow that's crazy. It's like, I've never heard it before. It's his. That stuff's amazing.
Started all this in the ninth grade. South Carolina where the heat stays. Never gets cold in the wintertime. That's why I might start with the beat plays.
And this, that's great. And then, unlike a lot of rappers, he has the ability to do a verse, and he pulls together hooks very well. That's him. He doesn't need a feature. A feature is just an added bonus. Shout out to Ruslan. Ruslan stays very, you know, connected with his fans. But again, I just love that. And then his third album, Come Out and Play, like I said, he experiments with sounds. The first album, I don't know what the heck that was. His second album, he was experimenting with sounds, but he was somewhere in like between my definition of chill hop and soft hop. He was there, right? Or lo-fi, but not exactly lo-fi. Yeah, whatever. We don't have an exact definition for it yet. But in this album, Come Out and Play, it's a much more darker album. Now, most of the times they save the darkness for the sequels. Like, Gavi came out with We Belong, then Panorama. And Panorama was the dark sequel. You know, if you've ever watched the X-Men movies, the first one's the more kiddish one. And the second one is the darker sequel that takes on more mature elements. Same thing with this, except that this is his third album. Come Out and Play, I mean, I'll show you the album cover in a second. But, he goes on for a much harder beat. It's a lot tougher. You feel it. Like, there's no way you can't not feel it. But it's some of the best music I've ever heard in my life. And I'm serious. Like, this is one of my all-time favorite songs. It does come from this album. It's called Supernova featuring Britton. I'm not gonna butcher that name. Here's the album cover so you guys can see. It's a lot darker, right? And the beats behind every single song on this album match it.
Money. Picture was always a plan. All these new faces becoming a fan. All of my time, put in the words. I cannot say without making it rhyme. I want the vibe. They want me ghost. I need respect. You do the most. You do the end. I'm giving a toast. I'm living so humble. How can I boast? Money can't make me rich. Money can't buy no friends. I used to think that they ride.
It's very good stuff. A lot of good stuff. His last album, Come Out and Play, came out 2019. You know, you might possibly be worried. You know, some artists make something so good they can't top it. Well, somehow he did. He proved that he can take on other genres. He literally came out after that album. He came out with a pop song. A freaking pop song. And the creepy thing is, it's really good. It's called In the Mill. Where does he get melodies and beats like that? What, do they just fall out of heaven right into the trap? I've been trying, but it's never enough. So why do I feel like this right now? Can somebody save me from myself somehow? I've been talking, you never let me speak. I'm not saying that I don't want you, just wanna feel like you want me to. I can't go on like this no more. I can't stand laying down on the floor. Could we meet right in the middle? Could we meet right in the middle? Could we meet? I mean, just, you know, mic drop, seriously. And then you're like, okay, so maybe he's pop, you don't know where he is yet, and then he drops this year, with an album cover that looks very much like a Lil Baby and Future song called Out the Mud. The chorus of this song is the same. I came out of the mud, or up from the mud. I mean, it's hard, but just, he's very versatile. One of the things that really got me to Adrian Singh's side is when I found out that he was in a band. And that just took him from here to here, because I thought I had heard it all. I thought he did everything that he possibly could have done. I was like, man, he did hard hip-hop, he did chill hip-hop, he did pop, he went straight back to hard hip-hop. There's nothing else he can do. And then I hear that he's in a band, and I hear the song, and I actually like it. And he became one of the, like, respected artists to me. And I'm just giving him the attention that he deserves. I hope lots of people find this video. I hope lots of people listen to his music, because he totally deserves it. This is his band. It's called After Midnight. That is catchy. And I gotta tell you, I like alternative. I mean, seriously though, I'm eclectic. That means I like a little bit of everything. I like hip hop. It's my favorite genre. But if I hear a good alternative song, if you don't know what alternative is, it can range anywhere from like a soft, almost pop feeling song to a softer rock song, which is most of alternative is a softer rock. Not all of it. You got your stuff like some of Paramore and a little bit of L City, and I like all of that. But I mean, Reliant K, I'm a huge fan of Reliant K, especially their album, I'm getting off course here, but I like me alternative, that's what I'm saying. And I know good alternative when I hear it. And I'm not gonna play the teaser of their new song, Waves, because I don't have Instagram on the iPod. But, yeah, if I had a camera on me, you would have seen me jump out of my chair and scream, because I freaked out. I heard it and I was like, I've been needing a good alternative song. Yes. Yeah, a lot more freaked out, but, I mean, seriously. These guys are great. Adrian is great. I mean, I wish I knew him in person. I haven't even mentioned all the facets of him. Because, like, yeah, that's great, but there's so much more. Like, he's got collaborations with Hilgi that are amazing. If you don't know who Hilgi is, he's another Christian rapper. And Adrian and him, they pair together so well. Their best song has got to be one called Stones. And I would say, though, probably a few of Adrian's songs, that they have a special place in my heart. From his EP in 2019 called No More Birthdays. Now, I got to tell you, a lot of artists, I haven't heard EPs that are really, they mean a lot. Like, I've heard EPs that mean a lot, but they're rare. They're very rare. I mean, right now I'm trying to think of them, and the only one that comes to my mind is The Arrow by Andy Mineo. I listened to that EP over and over for days because it was just so amazing. One of the best things I've ever heard. Same with this EP from Adrian Sings called No More Birthdays. It's raw, it's emotional, it strays a little bit away from the Christianness, but that's okay, because he's being raw here, and I think you feel it. This EP tackles depression, relationship issues, parenting issues, sin issues, demons, just everything. And the best stuff from this EP has got to be one of the songs, Demons. It has 5 tracks. It's so emotional, I almost cried the first time I heard this song. Call me a woman. I hear my demons, I hear them calling. I keep trying to get up, but I keep on falling. Will I ever break free from this nightmare, from reality? I mean, that is just so powerful to those lyrics. I hear my demons, I hear them calling. I keep trying to get up, but I keep on falling. Will I ever break free from this nightmare, from reality? If you haven't felt like that, you haven't ever gone through something or had to face your own demons. I feel like everybody has had to. It's crazy. It's such a good, powerful song. And the second one that's really powerful, all the songs are good on this EP. You got Sunshine and No More Birthdays, and it's 5 tracks. All of them are good. But the final one, One Day More, gets me. The way it's written, the chorus is structured, the story it tells, you know, you can relate to it, even though if your situation doesn't relate to the song. It's about him and his dad. Now it's just, and even though I don't necessarily relate to what's happening to him, the chorus I can relate to if I'm going through a relationship struggle with anybody. My heart's breaking from all this weight. I see the hurt, a lot of things are growing it down in the dirt. I'ma just hang on for the long haul, cause I'm a man now. Wherever you go, I pray that you turn back before you break down. Truly, truly great, truly amazing. As the song progresses, the chorus grows to almost like a true cry of desperation. You can feel it. I would say, if I'm going to quickly rank Adrian Sings albums, and I'll include the EP for this one, I would say my ranking goes, so 4 places. Four places. And I would go, 4th place is 1995. 3rd place is Come Out and Play. 2nd place is Odyssey. And 1st place will be No More Birthdays, the EP. I highly suggest you listening to Adrian Sings. Search him up. I'll put links to a couple of my favorite songs by him in the description. Please listen to him and his band. Very good stuff. Okay, so just tell me what you think of this video. I'm feeling like I'm ready to go full on for us, like a ton. This was the first episode, but I can go on with tons of artists on this. So subscribe, hit that like button, please comment, tell me what artists you might want to see on future JT picks, you know, because there might be artists that you're like, hey, JT, I feel like these people deserve it. These people deserve the highlight. Tell me. I read the comments. Share with your friends. Follow me on Instagram. If you got Apple Music, follow me on Apple Music. Till next time.